Take one. Bronzeville. Music. Art. Science. Politics. Young. Old. Joy. And yes, pain. Here, we will do our best to bring you the whole story. Bronzeville 360, local and global. More than a place or a race, join us on a journey through time and space. Yesterday, today, and forever. Bronzeville 360 degrees. On today's edition of Bronzeville 360, we visit an institution that has deep roots and represents much cultural significance in the story of Bronzeville, Wendell Phillips High School. The school was named after abolitionist Wendell Phillips, who devoted over 50 years of his life to humanitarian causes. Opened in 1904 as a predominantly white school, Phillips was designed to serve the children of wealthy families in the neighborhood, such as the Armors, Swifts, Pullmans, and McCormicks. These business moguls also allowed a few children of their black servants to attend the school. Driven largely by the population increase of the Great Migration at the turn of the century, by the time of the stock market crash of 1929, Phillips had become the first predominantly black high school in Chicago. For the past 100 years, Wendell Phillips High School's fortunes, for better or worse, have been intricately linked to the fortunes of the broader Bronzeville community. Through the hip and poppin' jazz age of the 1920s, through the careful development of a political power base that helped make the elections of Oscar DePriest, William Dawson, Mayor Harold Washington, and President Barack Hussein Obama possible. Through all of this change, Wendell Phillips High School has had its share of major ups and downs. The school boasts an impressive alumni, but due to many social and political factors over the years, often beyond its control, in 2010, the pendulum finally cut to the bone and the school was put on a turnaround status. The Academy for Urban School Leadership, also known as AUSL, a private management company, was given the contract to manage the turnaround of the school.
We greet you on behalf of Chicago Public Schools, and this meeting has been in the works for a while. And I believe this meeting is the beginning of what I hope and pray will be a fruitful partnership, and I salute AUSL's openness and willingness and commitment to being open and receptive to the community, and also encourage the community to keep your hands on this school. Because at the end of the day, we have one primary concern, and that's the outcomes for these students. Am I right?
This is not the first turnaround effort for Wendell Phillips High School.
We're really wrestling with the issues. This is no joke.
And this current effort has not been without controversy. It will take time, at least a year or two or three, to give a fair and comprehensive report on the turnaround success or failure. But the school, the community, and the effort demands thoughtful attention and broad-based support, because it is the students in the final analysis who will most feel the impact. On Bronzeville 360, we began a series of programs over the next few months that will explore the history of Wendell Phillips High School, its relationship to Bronzeville, its academic performance through the years, the impact of the Chicago Housing Authority plan for transformation, and the fast-track gentrification that the community is now experiencing. This can all get quite heavy and intense. And in future episodes, we plan to talk to as many people involved in the process as possible. To set the tone for today's program, we will focus our attention on three extracurricular programs that are trying to rebuild and reinforce school and community relations. We'll begin by looking at the new music program led by Mr. Wendell Macklin and his dedicated team of instructors. Then we'll go for a walk, a peace walk that is, led by a group of Wendell Phillips students who want to raise the social and spiritual awareness of area youth. And we'll explore the Parent Cafe, a monthly gathering of parents sponsored by several community partners at Wendell Phillips, including Youth Guidance, Project Strive, Centers for New Horizons, and the Bronzeville Alliance.
Parents more into the educational process. And that's one of the things that Tim and I really connected on when we met.
So put on your thinking caps and get ready for a real education as Bronzeville 360 begins its fascinating exploration of Wendell Phillips High School.
Really funny how sometimes some of the stuff is very simple.